Hey guys, so in this video we will going to talk about audience understanding. Okay, so when you will click here, you will going to see lots of information is given by this audience option here. Now we have taught you everything about interface, about real time. Right now you can see two active users. One is visiting my case study and another is visiting my CA Tanaj blog. Okay, now these are all the things which we have already discussed. Okay, in short overview. Now here we'll going to talk about audience. So it's name only suggestion that we will going to analyze our audience behavior. Okay, so if you will click on overview, so inside overview you will going to get each and every details about audience in very short summarized way. So here you can see there is lots of thing given, like how many users have visited my website, new users, session created, number of session per user, page views, pages, session, session duration, bounce rate, okay, new visitor, returning visitor, language, from language which people usually see inside my website, which demographic, which system, which modules, if you will going to select which country. Okay, so it will going to give you the country details where people usually visit to my website. You can see from India 536 users are there, from United States 24. Okay, so these are the things that is given in overview section. So overview section is just a summarized way of this audience section. In every section, if you will see inside acquisition also, you will going to see the overview option. Inside real time also, you will going to see the overview option. Inside audience also, you will going to see overview option. So overview option is just a summarized way of audience insight. So in real time, if you will click here, so overview inside the real time, it is a summarized report of location, traffic sources, content, event and conversion. So all will be summarized in the overview section. So inside, so like that, in audience also, overview is the summarized way of all this report. So if you want to see every of these details in brief, then you can go individually. Suppose I want to see active users, so I will going to see the very in-depth detail about the active users. So you can say one day 55 people were active users for my website, on last 7 days 586 people were, and in last 14 days around 892 people were active users. Okay, so it will going to tell you here, you can see date, okay, January 31st Feb. So there are lots of people who are visiting to my website, that is good. Here you can also compare the graph. For example, if you will click here, so it will also going to give you chart in the form of comparison. So you can compare every of your last 1 day active users with the last 7 days active users, with the last 14 days active users and last 28 active users. You can also customize and see the date. For example, if you want to see 21, you can click on 21 and then you can click on apply. So it will also going to give you the data for that specific date. Okay, so it's so simple, so easy. Okay, so I will again go for 3rd Feb. Today's 3rd Feb. So hope you have understood the idea. This is how this active users works. Now friends, here you will going to see we have one beta option. What is this beta option? Beta option means it is one new feature created by Google Analytics, but it is in testing mode. Okay, it is in still testing mode. So Google is testing it, how it is performing, and if Google will find that this beta version will be very much beneficial for Google Analytics users, then it will continue it. If Google will think that there is any more improvement that can be made inside this beta option, then it can also do that, or otherwise it will going to remove this option. So beta means it is a upcoming feature inside Google Analytics. Right now it is just in testing mode, okay, or testing period. Now here also, if you will see lifetime value, so it will going to give you lifetime value from where your website has started to till now, how it is performing. Okay, so it will give you every of the detail lifetime report. For example, from social, around 1398 users have come from direct, 569 users have come to my website from referral, 476 people have come to my website. So total becomes 2626 users who have on total visited to my website. Revenue and revenue per user and revenue will also going to show up here. So this is the lifetime data. It is now in testing mode. Okay, now friends, here if you will go to overview section, here I want to tell you one thing. Here you can also compare your overview data. For example, right now it is selected as all users. You can see it is selected as all users. Okay, now for example, if you want to compare all users data, okay, all user data with your direct traffic. For example, so you, what you can do, you can click on this ad segment, and from here you can select the direct traffic. So Google Analytics will going to compare report with the all users plus direct traffic. If you will click here and if you will click on apply, so Google will give you a comparison between all users and direct traffic. Okay, so you can just analyze it. Like for example, here you can see all users have just increased and decreased, then increased high, but in direct it is has increased, decreased, increased. Okay, so this way you can just compare data. From here you can see all users are 55, but out of those all users, direct traffic were 21. Okay, so this is how you can compare. So for example, if you only want to see direct traffic, so you can just go here. From here you can click on remove. So now here you will only going to see the direct traffic data. Okay, let's cancel it. Now here, from here you can just see direct traffic data. Everything is given or every report is generated for only direct traffic data. Okay, so you can also create more segments and more segments. For example, if I want to compare it with mobile and tablet traffic, then it will show. You can add more. Okay, for example, if you want to check with the bounce session, so you can compare every data if you want to. So like that, you can see if direct traffic is shown by blue symbol, mobile and traffic is shown by orange line, and bounce session is shown by green line. So like that, you can compare. If you want to delete, you can delete it. For example, if I want to delete direct traffic, remove it. I also want to remove this, and I want only all users. Okay, so it will automatically get set to all users. So this is the overview power. Okay, you can compare data with each other. Now friends, here you will going to see lifetime. We have already discussed about lifetime. Now we have this cohort analysis. Now what is this? This is not possible you to understand this feature right now. We will going to discuss about this feature after some time when you will going to learn lots of settings, how to create goals and everything, and after you will learn those things, then only you can easily understand this thing. Right now we will going to leave it. Okay, then inside demographics, or let's go to audience section. Inside audience, you can see there are not lots of people, okay, in users also, because it is in cohort analysis. We will going to discuss about this in later time, but let's go for a demographic. Inside demographic, you will see the overview option if you want to go for a specific age. So you will going to see the age data. Right now it is not showing me, no problem. Okay, then here you can see gender, that means how many gender people have come to your website, male, female. So these are the all the data that we're going to show you here. Now interest, if you will click on interest here, it is affinity category. So now friends, just go to in market segment. So in market segments data will also going to show here. Now you might be wondering, what is this affinity category and in market category? So affinity category, if you have watched our Google Ads course, so there we have taught you that affinity categories people are those people who actively ready to do something. If you will go to this affinity category, meaning affinity category people used to reach potential customers to make them aware of your brand or products. These are the users higher in the purchase funnel near the beginning of the process. Okay, so these are the people who can easily get converted. And in market segment are those people who do active research. For example, if you also see the meaning of this in market segment Google Analytics, so here you can see in market audience is a way to connect with consumers who are actively researching or comparing products and services. Okay, so affinity people are those people who are ready to get aware about your brand or products. In market segment people are those people who are just putting lots of time or efforts on researching about your product and services. So those people analytics will also going to show up here. Okay, so for that you need to connect your analytics with the Google Ads account. Okay, so don't worry, we will going to teach you that also. Inside geo you will see the language, that means how many people from which language are seeing our content or website. So here you can see people who speak English language from US generally see my content. You can see they contain around 927 users, new users are 906, sessions created by them are 1164. So like that, there are lots of language. Now location means from where people are seeing my content, so those are also be going to show here. You can see from India around this much of people are my users, from new users from my India is 1816. Okay, session are created 2434 sessions are being created by Indian users. And like that you can see United States, Bangladesh, Nepal, UAE, Bhutan, Pakistan, Egypt, Qatar. So there are lots of people from different countries visiting my website, and their analytics is shown here how they perform with my website. Okay, so their users, new users, sessions, bounce rate, pay session, and there are lots of data that are shown here. You can see right now goal conversion rate, goal value. So these are data are empty right now. If you will click on admin, so here you will going to see this goal option. So right now we haven't set any goal option, so that's the reason it is not showing right now. But yes, when we will going to connect or create our goal, then it will start going to show all the data there. Okay, so this is the location part inside our Google Analytics. Let's scroll down. Okay, now very easy behavior, that means how people are behaving inside your website. So new versus returning means how many people are new and how many people are returning to your website again. So their data is also given by Google Analytics. So you can see new users are around 2000 who have visited to my website, and there are 280 visitors who have already visited my website, but they have visited my website again. So there are total 280 users. So their information is also shared here, frequency and recency. Here it will going to give you the all session related data, like for one person, how many session has been counted, for two. So as it grows, it will become lesser. Okay. Now engagement, how many people are engaged with your website. So you can see there are some people who just created session for 0 to 10 seconds. There are some people they have created session for 0 to 30 seconds. There are some people even who have created the session 601 to 1800 seconds. Okay, so I have already taught you what is session. Session means when someone visit to my website and their session also gets end. Okay, so this is the time it is given, when session has started to when session has ended. So here you can see people, there are sessions who have started and they have ended here, and around 195 session has been created there. So like that, this is the engagement area. Now technology, if you will click on browser and OS, so here it will going to give you the data about people, how they are visiting to your website. So from here you can see from Chrome, around this much people have visited to my website. From Android web view, this much. From Safari, this much. Safari app, from this one, Samsung internet, this one, Edge, this one, Firefox, this one users. So according to the network, it is giving you relevant data. Networks, so from which network people are coming to my website. Right now I don't think so it will show, like that I have told you, not set. Okay, so it is not set yet. So but they are still showing that there are many data from where it is showing, but don't worry, in your case it will going to show. Okay, I will teach you how you can do that. Now in mobile, so that means how people have visited to my website with the help of which device. So that is what it is showing. So that is what it is going to show here. So from here you can see from Apple iPhone, lots of people have visited. From Xiaomi, this much people have visited. From Samsung mobile, people have visited. So like that, there are lot many data. If you will click here, okay, if you will just scroll down here, you will going to see. Right now it is just showing me one. If you will click here, you will going to see more data. Okay, so there are lots of data you can see. You can see Realme, from Realme, around this many people have visited to my website. So like that, you can also trace the data. And right now, like I usually come to know that from Apple iPhone, people usually visit to my website. So what I can do, when I can make one advertisement or I can make one marketing decision, so I can just target to people who use Apple iPhone. Okay, so this is the thing. Now custom. So guys, custom means you can create your custom data. So okay, you can see your user defined. So according to that, you can create or customize your data. I will going to teach you how you can do that. Right now you do not need to get worried. Benchmark means you can set one target for your channel, location and devices. That means if you will click on channel, so it will going to give you lots of additions and subtraction. So from here you can see the benchmark session. Okay, so you can create more benchmark, you can choose more benchmark. So with the help of those benchmark, you can compare data. Suppose if you will going to select that my social must be around 50%. Okay, if you will going to set your social as 50%, so it will be created as one benchmark. So if someone will go above your benchmark, then it will going to show above arrow. If someone will go less to the benchmark you have decided, then it will going to see, then it will going to show like this. Okay, red arrow. So like this, you can create benchmarks for different things, for locations, for devices and many more. Okay, so like that also, here you can see the benchmark. You can create more benchmarks. For example, you can select more benchmark from your new benchmark session. Okay, on the basis of views and everything. So here you can also select the benchmark. For example, if you will set your benchmark to 60%, so if someone will go above 60, it will show green, or otherwise it will show red. So simple. User flow, it will going to give you actual road of your website. For example, here you can see that from India around 2.4k people have come, and they from there around 12.2% of traffic has visited to my course, and then after visiting to the course they have visited to this page, courses class 12 page, and after that some people have visited to this page. Okay, so like that you can see the flow. From here you can see around 62 people have visited to my website. This is the last 7 days data. So 62 people from United States visited to my website. They have gone to this area, courses class 12. Then after that they have gone to first here in this courses for class 12, and like that you can see the total flow of your website, how people are moving inside your website, how Indian people are going in which page. From here you can see the loss of Indians who are seeing my this blog, CA Web of Taneja. Okay, from you can see around here you can see Web of Taneja around 0. Or I can say around 7%. Okay, 7% traffic of the total traffic. That means out of 2.4k, around 7% people are visiting to this blog, CA Web of Taneja blog. So like that you can see the total flow inside your website. So this is the user flow option which you will going to get inside your audience option. So hope you have understood the lots of things. So what you need to do, you need to explore this Google Analytics account. You can just open your Google Analytics account and you have to just go and see where you can find which data. Okay, you just have to put lots of effort inside Google Analytics, and you will step by step, slowly you will going to understand each and everything. Okay, so you have to just learn inside active users what are the data that are shown inside user explorer, inside demographics, inside custom, inside user flow, how people are performing. So you just have to put your eye on your Google Analytics account and you have to just explore and you have to analyze what's going and what are these things. Okay, you can see here people here Google Analytics is giving us meaning. If you will click here, Google Analytics is again giving us details. You can read this, understand this. So there are lots of things. You just have to put efforts inside your Google Analytics account. So hope you have understood the idea about audiences. So this was all about today's video, guys. I will see you in the next video. Thank you.